In this video, I wanted to discuss autistic rights. Now, by autistic rights, I don't mean that we as autistic people rebel against the non-autistic population, but what I'm suggesting is that what concerns me at the moment is the fact that the way that people on the spectrum are being treated, and in my own situation, I find that I now don't have a GP, and I'm sort of everything I feel that's around me is being dismantled, and decisions are being made about me that I don't necessarily see as compatible, and I'm virtually misunderstood and often not able to communicate where I can to people around me. I've also experienced recently a terrible anxiety attack, and this anxiety attack is to the point where it's just difficult to think and function correctly. And it is a very debilitating situation to be in this, because from what I can see, the world is become evil, and the world has lost the plot, and it's mainly the non-autistic population that are stuffing things up more and more because things aren't working properly. And I don't want to sound like I'm a soothsayer, but it sounds like to me the world is heading in a very perilous and uncertain future. What concerns me primarily in the global situation is the election of Donald Trump as president. Now, I'm not saying that Hillary Clinton is anything better, but perhaps the agenda is to have someone like Donald Trump, who could be quite unstable at a global position. Let me just concentrate on this. Let me just ask you to think about this for a moment. I don't follow religion and politics. In my opinion, that to me, they have irrelevancy. I couldn't care less. I despise the fact that I have to pay tax to politicians, even though I understand that I have to pay tax and that it's required or whatever, and I find that is something that I've had to hand on to an accountant because it's beyond me, I can't do it anymore. But just take, for example, a scenario where there is the insidious force that is against the West and that is wanting to have someone like Donald Trump as a leader to create a holy war, for example, to create a jihad on a global scale. And what concerns me is that I just don't know whether I feel confident that having someone like Donald Trump in charge of a military industrial complex. Now, I can't say that I trust Hillary Clinton either, but it seems to me that the world is becoming more and more paralyzed to, let's just say you have a point A and a point B. Just say there's a track that, or a path or whatever that links point A to point B. What's happening in the world is this, all this obstruction and all this uncertainty for most, in a lot of scenarios, where it's difficult to get from point A to point B. And what I can also sense is the fact that I think the financial system is collapsing. The world is drastically overpopulated, and the resources and the monetary system cannot meet the demands of this overpopulation. But getting back to Donald Trump, for example, if you have someone like him and you have people that are in charge of, now with Hillary Clinton, for example, she's not really white either. I don't want to get involved in personalities, but at least she has some political experience, whereas Donald Trump, in my opinion, is very unknown, and it's very concerning what he might be like being tested on a global scale. I don't primarily think that the world can go back to the 1950s or back to the old way of balancing budgets and keeping everything under scrutiny, because I think there's just, if you look at it, for example, the left-wing politics is becoming more and more evident because there's a greater need for welfare, a greater need for the means of sustaining people that are unemployable. And that is why I think there's a tremendous drain on the resources and on the financial system that's happening in this world. But if Donald Trump does become president, how stable is the world going to be in terms of having a accountability, an authority or whatever? And also Donald Trump gets under my skin because I don't like his stance towards vaccines. He is anti-vaccine. And I'm saying Hillary Clinton, she's not much better either. But I personally feel that autistic people at the moment, we're being seen more and more as a burden. The world, people want to medicate us because we are a threat. And they want to find ways, because they can't deal with us, they've got to find ways to try to control us or hope that we perish as people. And I don't want to get into the anti-vaccination debate anyhow, but I really would like you to think about what's going on in America at the moment and perhaps look at the overpopulation question. And I also would encourage you to think, where is this world heading and what direction is it heading? You know, I find, for example, that when I try to get things, and I'm feeling it at the moment, like there's a lot of pressure on me to leave. There's a lot of pressure on me to go because I'm misunderstood. I'm a problem. I'm a burden. I like, in an environment where there's young minds and there's people that want to get ahead, my role primarily is I want to build people up. I want to build young people up, but they don't understand me. They misconstrue where I'm coming from. They think that I'm after them for some, you know, other motive. I'm not after them for that motive. All I want to do is I feel concerned about younger generations because I feel that without the guidance and support and the assistance that can be afforded to them, that their mental health and their future is uncertain. And I want to build people up. I don't think about myself first and foremost, folks, only to the point where I have to defend myself. But, for example, in an environment where there are students, my response is to make the environment supportive and to make it a place where young people can get the help and the assistance that they need to be able to become efficient and effective in their particular roles in and stations in life. I prefer to be to doing that than to being some zombie that's just supposed to just think, oh, at the end of the day, all I'm concerned about is a paycheck. Well, the monetary system is, in my opinion, one of the most frustrating things on this planet, because wherever money is concerned, yes, it does have its benefits, but it also causes so much grief. The taxation, the other aspects that also have to be met with it as well. What I would prefer to see is an exchange of intellectual ability and a productivity in terms of intellectual stimulation and outcome and performance. So I've covered a whole lot of topics in this video today, and I know there are a lot of people that hate my guts. They don't understand me. They perceive me as a threat or whatever. I'm not interested in politics. I'm not interested in competing with people. I'm not interested in the political system. I'm not interested in the religious system. All I want to do is I want to be able to see things happening and working properly on this planet. I want to be able to see an environment where infrastructure doesn't let people down. I want to see an environment where people come out and become qualified and exceptional people so that they can provide that expertise into the community to make it a better community, to have more effective and productive outcome. So whether you like me or you loathe me, my message primarily to you today is to have a re-examination on ways that this planet can be going more forth in a direction of productivity and prosperity. Thanks very much for watching this video.